And here we have our redbud tree. The redbud tree is an understory tree, meaning it's meant to only be about 15 feet high. It's not gonna get as tall as our oaks and our maples do. So you'll find it growing in the understory of our forests. The leaves are very distinct shape. They make a perfect heart shape. So if you fold them in half, they're symmetrical. And it has entire margins, meaning the margins are smooth. So if you see a perfectly smooth heart-shaped leaf, think of our heart pumps red blood. It's a red bud tree. One of the other characteristics of the red bud are these tiny little purplish pink flowers. They come out typically right off of the branch of the tree. They look like little pea flowers. The seeds, I feel like, are distinctive also. The seeds look like flattened pea pods. They start off green, but then will turn brown by the end of fall, and they persist on the tree throughout the winter. Red buds are in the legume family, which is one of the reasons why their seeds look like flattened pea pods. And fun fact, you can take the flowers and the seed pods and eat them. There's no nutritional value to them, but it's always fun to put it on a salad. Also, if you look at the branching of a red bud tree, it makes a zigzag pattern. So everywhere where a leaf had come out before, the branch turned just a little bit. So in the winter, you can really tell the red buds by the zigzag pattern on the branches. The bark of the red bud tree is typically this brownish and flaky bark, and it will be multi-trunked like this. Red bud trees very rarely have a single leader trunk. Usually they come out with multiple trunks. And that's our red bud tree.